Hello, everyone. Cloud7 here, and welcome back to More Okami. I am back from New York. I did fail to mention that last time, but I did not think I was going to be I did not know about heading over to New York at that time. So I decided to leave a little note mentioning the change of plans in the description of the last stream that I exported over to YouTube. Now, brief recap. Last time, we went over to Queen Himiko's palace to talk to, give her a little, talking to about her failing to help out with the city. We talked for a bit, and now she told us to head over to North Hiroshima Coast, as that is where we will find the Dragonians, the people responsible for the Water Dragon. And we also ended off on a sour note because, I didn't have enough money to do a little something. So in this episode, first we're going to be handling that little unfinished business, doing it with a little something. And then we are going to be trying to find the Dragonian Palace. Where is it? Is it not on this island? Ugh, great. And I failed to stick the landing. Lovely. I already do not remember where the island is supposed to be. So I already did this one. Okay. Hello, stupid water dragon. Oh, jeez. Yeah, we already know that, so let's go find it already. Hiyo, Orca, away! Thank you. Is this it? Here it is. Found it. The bite of Taijigami's power slash got more powerful? Does that mean you can cut hard things you couldn't cut before? Boy, I can't wait to get tried out. I can't wait either, Isun. Power slash 2. Alright. Let's see. Reveal the power hidden within by mastering power slash 2. Substances like iron that were too strong to cut before can be sliced. Oh, you better bet I'm gonna be making use of this little trick. That one has. Nope. Oh, come on! What's this? You know what? I'll worry about it. I'll worry about it on my own time. Oh. Here. Man, I'm having the memory of a goldfish right now. I could have sworn there might have been like one or two iron rocks here. Oh, jeez. Hiyo, orca, away! Well, back to the coast. Well, it's like, who's sworn there was a chest around here somewhere? I found it while I was out just, like, grinding, farming for yen. Here it is! There we go, crystal. Thank you. Huh? Someone there? This is the Watcher's Cape. It's said the gods once used this place to return to the heavens. At night, this place offered a great view of the starry sky. Even the Whirlpool Galaxy was visible from the Cape's tip. Whirlpool Galaxy? It's a group of stars. They form the shape of a great spiral like a heavenly whirlpool. Since the demon-shaped island appeared out at sea, there are more and more monsters about, and the skies have dulled. The magnificent starry view can no longer be seen. You can't see the stars in the middle of the day. When night falls, I got a wish to make upon a shooting star. If you can wish upon a star, it always comes true. Even the Whirlpool Galaxy might appear in the sky again. Whirlpool, huh? Yeah. So that's how I'm supposed to do it. Yes, prior to this very playthrough, I have had trouble with this particular part of the game. Whirlpool shall open up below. Didn't Orca say the entrance to the Dragon Palace is a whirlpool? But I don't really get this when the Whirlpool Galaxy spins part. What was the whole thing that Isu said? Watcher's Cape. When the Whirlpool Galaxy spins in the distant heavens, a whirlpool shall open up below. That whirlpool picture kind of looks like a windmill or something. Why is this place called Watcher's Cape anyway? The view is nothing to write home about. I think I have an idea of what to do now. But first, aha! I have a feeling there's one here somewhere. And it's a dog statue. I can't shake the feeling I'm forgetting something. Oh, of course. Took me one look at the plus button. With the new, as per usual, as per tradition, with a new enemy comes a new bestiary entry, Blue Cyclops. This curmudgeonly blue brute usually flies and smokes a pipe. If its pipe goes out, it becomes enraged and calls forth lightning. However, relighting the pipe will calm it down almost instantly. And new treasures. Dog statue. Looks very loyal and obedient. It's also known as man's best friend. Twin whirlpools. Let's see. It says, when the Whirlpool Galaxy spins in distant heavens, the whirlpool shall open up below. I'm here in the hope I'll be able to make a wish. Shooting stars are rare now, not like before. If only a star would shoot from across this night sky, then I can make a wish upon it. If you wish upon a star, it will always come true. Even the Whirlpool Galaxy might appear in the sky again. Why don't you stand next to me and help me look for shooting stars? There, a shooting star! I gotta make my wish right now! I wish that the sky was as magnificent as it was in the past, and that the Whirlpool Galaxy was visible again. That's it! The Whirlpool Galaxy! My wish really did come true! Wow, check out that whirlpool of stars. It's like a huge windmill in the night sky. They say the Whirlpool Galaxy is the key to the Dragon Palace. If so, then the Whirlpool entrance should be somewhere under it. The sea looks pretty calm to me. That Whirlpool Galaxy isn't even swirling. What are we gonna do to make that Whirlpool entrance appear? I think I have a clue. I think you're onto something. Maybe we're supposed to blow that star whirlpool round and round. Try it again, Ami. You keep using that wind power of yours. Look! Whirlpool entrance to the Dragon Palace! The Whirlpool Galaxy is bringing it to the surface! Okay, homie, it's about time we got down to that Dragon Palace. Let's go teach those Dragonians a lesson. They're gonna pay for not keeping that water dragon under on a leash. Hiya, Orca, away! Dragon Palace. Finally, Ami! We made it through that whirlpool down to the bottom of the sea! So this must be the Dragon Palace in the Kingdom of... This must be the Dragon Palace in the Kingdom of the Dragonians. Their leader, Otohime, controls the Water Dragon. We better not let our guard down. And we got a bunch of chests to open, or in this case, clams. But they're still basically the same thing as chests. You talking to us? Who do you think you are talking to us like that? Besides, you're the ones who let that water dragon run amok. I'm Isun, wandering artist of the take. Now hurry up and go fetch your leader Ultohime for me. Chop chop! I've no time for lonely servants. What are you two babbling on about? You gonna go get Ultohime or not? Just like at Sasa Sanctuary, there's a little secret below the stairs. Only, whereas in Sasa Sanctuary, it's a bunch of rats to feed. Here, it's a cracked wall that leads to a hole. Godly charm. Kutani pottery. Alright. So I still can't upgrade anything. Boo! I'm going for Astral Pouch anyway. Wait, no. There we go. Chest, give me the chest. Exorcism slip. S. Scrolls underwater. You're telling me. What are those scrolls made out of? Thank you. I couldn't care less who or what you are. All I'm interested is in that lady sitting on her rump over there. It's your daddy, right? Well, we have some choice words for her. Leader of the Dragonians, Otohime. Anyway, we wanted to ask you something. You know that water dragon that's been running amok lately? It's under your control, right? Well, why don't you keep that thing on a leash? And what's with sending your emissary to come get us? Are you really that desperate? What the? You know about Ami? So you're saying that control of the water drain? You gotta be kidding me! The water dragon is supposed to break the barrier on Oni Island. What hope do we have of attacking the enemy if it won't help us? Can you already say something about this? No. Fuck, we don't need to hear all that stuff again. We can't break the barrier on Oni Island without the water dragon. Himiko prayed so long and hard to locate that dang island, and now we can't even get on it. Come on, Ami. You're a god, ain't ya? Don't you have some secret weapon hidden up your sleeve? There is? Why didn't you just say so? Probably wants to go tie a leash around the dragon, right? Well, we're not gonna do anything crazy like that. It's not like we couldn't pull it off or anything. Right, Ami? I mean, Orca would probably help us out, right? Dragon Heart, what's that? You're saying we can just forget about the water dragon and go hunt for the dragon heart thing? Sounds like a piece of cake. I mean, we're treasure hunting bros. Here it comes. Why isn't the belly of the water dragon? Come again? Now wait just a second, Lainey. Go get some more from the Mara Dragon's stomach? Are you nuts? You already said that before, lady! Whoa, slow down there, sister. I make it a habit of never saying no to a pretty face, but if my boss here says no, there ain't much I can do. Well, boss, we gonna help this chick or what? Help Otohime? Ah, hell, why the hell not? Bomber, well, the boss is spoken. Huh? Shelly amulet. Water Dragon's garden? Here? At this palace? That thing lives here? Look at the mess we're in now! Why are you always so eager to please? Ah, forget it. Let's go get that barrier-breaking orb. The Water Dragon's garden should be around here somewhere. Before we head over to the Water Dragon's lair, there's something else I want to get first. But first, I'm going to save. Because, this involves another digging minigame. Yep, bomb is dropped there. This next part that I'm going to be doing involves another digging minigame. Bullhorn. I'm not the size of Isud. How is this thing so humongous? Well, street beat. Vengeance slipped. What the hell are you doing? No, not really. Doesn't it seem like we've been meeting a lot of girls lately? I mean, how long is it been since we ran into a guy? I only have hope they don't take advantage of me. Why am I voicing this dude again? This bug? He's probably gonna kick my ass for calling him that. I'm not answering that. Sure. I'm fine. How do I do this again? Thank you. Made it. Yeah, right on. Wahoo. Great. Fantastic. The world's gone? Muta got me again. Oh, well, good luck with that. Boy, homie, that's one mean brush you wield. I bet you could summon one of those time travel world, those travel whirlpools anytime you want if you use that technique on a mermaid spring. Yeah, we could travel across Nippon for free. Get some face to help people every now and then. So yes, now there's little to no backtracking. There's little to no backtracking now. Woohoo! Scroll drawn by wandering. Yep, yep. Draw a swirl on the surface of a mermaid spring's water, and Mars Bow's ultimate power fountain shall be revealed. This miraculous power can instantly teleport you to faraway lands. With that, I'm gonna go save. And then get ready for the water dragon. What the? It's that pesky water dragon. How many times that rampaging sea monster almost finished us off? So it makes it some here, huh? That's one huge, nasty-looking mouth on that thing. Think we really could go in there and come back out alive? I mean, we're not talking about the Emperor's stomach here. Yeah. But it is definitely Lord Jabu Jabu's belly. It is most certainly Jabu. Hey, my street beat. Infinity Stone. Inside the Dragon. Oh, here we are. This is the War Dragon's stomach, huh? Is it just me, or is it unbearably hot and humid here? With the way this dragon is running amok, I'm sure we'll see all sorts of gruesome things down here. I just hope I don't lose my lunch. Think we're really gonna find that dragon orb in here, Ami? I don't know about the dragon orb, but I do know we're most certainly gonna be finding lots of treasure here. Infinity Stone. That actually surprised me. I was not expecting that. Holy bonus. Wait, nope, that leaves the larger one. Bullhorn. Exorcism Soap S. Seriously? You gotta be kidding me here. Yeah. I want all of the treasures. Much better. heel. Soul sucking. Steel fist sucking. Pearl. Exorcism flip M. Incense burner. Crystal. What's that? It's all tangled up in all this flabby stomach muscle. It's like a glass ball or something. A dead end? I don't know where we are now. I don't like the look of that red liquid there. It'll probably digest us in a second if we fell in. What the heck are you doing? The red liquid is raining now. What happened if that fleshy mass dissolves? Now you got me interested too. What the whole place is flooded with that icky red liquid. You can't even find the dragon orb. Now I end up lunch. I'm starting to think it's a bad idea to have the thieves have this thing equipped. You obtained a dragon orb. Nice work, Ami. Finally got that dragon orb. Now we should be able to break the barrier on Oni Island. Once Yumiko locates the island on her crystal ball, the enemy strongholds will be totally exposed. Boy, you sure had a hard time pulling that orb out. Where are the dragons gonna be okay? Let's go, Ami. I mean, we got the orb. No use sticking around here. What the heck? Are these the vengeful spirits of the people the dragon gobbled up? No way. These aren't spirits. That weird color can only mean one thing. Foxfire. That's it. You obtained fox rods. What the heck was that? It was kind of freaky. Looked like a bundle of bamboo tubes or something. I know. I bet those are the fox rods that Pussy Babe wanted. You know, that ultimate weapon against the Dark Lord. Ugh, I knew it. You should have tried to pull that orb out more gently. I'm too young to be digested. Let's get out of here. The water dragon, it's dead. Now what are we supposed to do? We have the dragon orb, but no water dragon for it to control. No matter how hard Himiko tries to locate Oni Island, without that dragon, there's no way we can break the barrier. Hey, something's coming.
Amaterasu, origin of all that is good, and mother to us all. I'm afraid there's no time left for me to speak now. But I do need to thank you.
What for? And who are you anyway?
I am King Wada.
The 27th King of the Dragonians.
King of the Dragonians? So then you were that water dragon.
It was I, the water dragon, god of the sea, ruler of the deep.
Oh, great god Amaterasu.
As you well know, there are ill omens heralding the coming of great strife throughout Nippon. Even the Dragonians have suffered under the forces of darkness. They seek to prevent me from using my power. The power to break the barrier that protects Oni Island. I waged battle against the Dark Lord and consumed the dark instrument he wielded.
but the instrument lodged in my stomach and drove me to madness.
Instrument of the Dark Lord? You mean this thing?
Yes, the Fox Rods. Without the Fox Rods, the Dark Lord has limited power. Now all the monsters are doing everything they can to locate them.
I see. They're like a key to his power or something.
I can rest easy knowing they are in your hands, Amaterasu.
I also ask you give my wife Otohime the dragon orb. It is the heart of the dragon. It will bring peace to my people. Alas, my end is near. I have slain many innocents while in the grip of madness. I pray that their souls may rest in peace in these watery depths. These deep blue waters the people of Hiroshima Coast so dearly love. Farewell, Amaterasu.
I shall pray for your good fortune.
You don't have to worry about us. I mean, nothing can stop Olami here. Not fire, not water, not... Hey, it's not nice to interrupt. I was on a roll, babe. Anyway, the water dragon was actually the Dragonian King. He turned into a dragon to protect the Dragon Palace. He even snatched these fox rods from their boss.
Come to think of it, weren't you looking for these
Aren't they the ultimate weapon against the evil beings?
Hey, wait a sec. What about what you said about the fox rods? You know, about the ship sinking before they reached Himiko?
Why'd you have to search that stupid ship if they weren't really there?
Now you just hold on with your nose, baby. I mean, if those monsters are frantically searching for them, whoever has them will have a huge bullseye on their back.
Hope you know what you're doing, you big furball.
With your life? Don't go getting yourself killed, babe.
Ugh, she's gone.
Hey, Omi. Quit spacing out. We gotta deliver that dragon orb we got from the Water Dragon to Otohime right away. Probably can't count on the power of the Water Dragon anymore. The Dragonians still consider the dragon orb as their treasure. You better return it to them. First thing is first. Let's bloom this thing right away. Treasure box. Bring your Legion an instant. I'm back, baby. About that, but what about that water dragon? It sunk to the bottom of the sea when we took that orb thing. Does that mean the king of the Dragonians is... is that king of the Dragonians really your... Oh, you mean the fox rods? Queen Yumiko's attendant took it. She said something about using its power against the evil beings. Yikes! What's up with this thing? Come on, Ami! No time to explain now, babe. We gotta get over to Onkoku Temple quick. Intense burner.
Whoa, it's the birthday day, huh? She's gone.
Wait, hey, wait, she wants us to follow her? Not again. Where does she want us to go? What the? You see that, homie? The busty babe went right through the wall. There's a body here. It looks like it's been laying here forever. There's none but bones and some clothing left. Now where have I seen clothes like that before? Huh? Isn't this Himiko's palace? Why is there a tunnel from Onkoko Temple to here? Hey dudes, what the heck happened? She passed out. You're about to see why I don't trust that woman. Why I don't trust this woman. Huh? What the heck happened? Hey, pretty lady, Himiko. She's dead. Pussy babe, is that you? What monster are you talking about? That ginormous thing that attacked you at Onkoku Temple? Dang it! Himiko said she'd be okay as long as she had that crystal ball. So how the heck did this happen? Hey, Ami, why do you keep staring at the pussy babe? Himiko's dead. Aren't you the least bit sad? What's wrong, Ami? Down, Ami! Huh? What the? What's up with those freaky eyes of yours? You're freaking me out. Ami, where's the busty babe we know and love? She's really the Dark Lord? The Grand Master of Evil Beings? Ami, remember the Dragonian's revelation? He was showing us how Foxface here killed the real Busty Bane. Boy, she's a real good faker. She had me totally fooled. And look what she did to poor little Himiko. Well, at least we won't have to worry about Oni Island anymore. We're gonna finish you off right here. Okay, we have her now, Ami. Let's finish off that foxhead wench.
Ignorant fools, did you really think it would be that easy? I have powers beyond belief. Here is but a taste of what the Dark Lord can do.
Petty deity, it is only the size of this room that saved you. It is far too small for me to unleash my true fury. However, resistance is futile, for your last remaining hope is gone. I shall now return to Oni Island and rally my dark forces. Then we'll go forth and crush all who stand against the darkness. Not this time, Ninetales.
Matarasu had followed the Dark Lord and allowed the Dark Lord to slip away. The display of evil sent chills down the wolf's spine. Amaterasu and Isun were left to wallow in overwhelming sadness, but Himiko had remained steadfast in her quest to find Oni Island. In the end, she lost her life at the hands of the Dark Lord. With Himiko dead, all clues to Oni Island. With Himiko, died all clues to the location of Oni Island. Matarasu and Isun were left with nary a shred of hope. Giving up on their quest seemed the only option. That's when they noticed that the blood-caked crystal ball spewed forth by the Dark Lord clearly displayed an image of Himiko. Isun, doubting his eyes, listened intently as Himiko began speaking. She explained that Oni Island would not be easy to find, and that she had determined to become ethereal and enter the crystal ball herself in search of clues. She had allowed herself to be consumed in order to use the Dark Lord's power. She was also aware that the ball the Dark Lord now possessed. All the fox rods, all was planned. Himiko's will infused the crystal ball with great power. The fortress housing the dark forces materialized. Oni Island appears only at sunset in a certain location. The place revealed by the crystal ball was none other than a spot just off the northwest shore of Ryoshima Coast, near the spot known as Watcher's Cape. Oni Island would appear again at Watcher's Cape at the next sunset. A small glimmer of hope returned to our heroes' hearts. Just as the image of Oni Island faded from the crystal, a deep crack appeared and split Himiko's image. She paid the ultimate price for manipulating the dark power. The crystal itself had been spent. The destiny of Himiko's very soul had been inextricably intertwined with that of the crystal ball. A burst of blinding light heralded the crystal's demise. Himiko's soul was caught up in the shattered fragments and drifted serenely toward the heavens above, even as she prayed fervently for Amaterasu's safe passage. Ami, the sun's gotta set soon. Oni Island's gonna disappear. That revelation Himiko risked her life to tell us. Whatever we do, we can't let it go to waste. Who cares if we can't break the bear on our own? Let's make a beeline for Watcher's Cape, Ami.
Actually, we're gonna end off on a little cliffhanger. We're gonna end off on a cliffhanger. Because I'm running a little bit low on time here. So unfortunately, I won't be able to head over to Oni Island right now. Alright. Next time on Okami, we are going to be heading right over to Oni Island and face off against the Dark Lord, Ninetales, and end off the second arc. See you next time.